In this video, I'm gonna explain why exposure compensation is necessary and why it does not work on manual mode. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador from Helsinki, Finland. And in this video, I'm going to explain what exposure compensation is, why it's necessary, and why it does not work on manual mode. But before that, I'd like to apologize for my voice. I've had this really persistent flu for about a week now. But it's not coronavirus. Yesterday I took the test and this morning I got the negative result. But anyway, it's really, really annoying. But now to the topic of the day, which is exposure compensation. And the reason for this video is that I get these questions on a regular basis about the exposure compensation and especially why it does not work on manual mode. Whenever you use any of the automatic exposure modes, PA or S, the camera will choose at least one of the exposure values. And by doing that, the camera will also determine the brightness of the picture. But if you want your picture to be brighter or darker than what the camera chose, you have to use the exposure compensation to override the camera settings. And if you are on P mode and you apply exposure compensation, that will change either the aperture, shutter speed, or both, depending on the situation. If you are on A mode, aperture priority, and you apply exposure compensation, that will change the shutter speed. And if you are on S mode, shutter priority mode, and you apply exposure compensation, that will change the aperture. However, if you have the auto ISO activated, the exposure compensation can also change that depending on the situation. On manual mode, as the name implies, you set all the exposure values, the aperture, shutter speed, and ISO manually. And by selecting the exposure values, you determine the brightness of the picture. And if you want a darker or brighter picture, you just select different exposure values. And therefore, the exposure compensation is not needed and it's not also working on manual mode. However, if you turn on the auto ISO on manual mode, you can use the exposure compensation. And whenever you apply the exposure compensation, it will change the ISO value. But it does not work on every Lumix camera. It works on the G9, G90, GX9, for example, and it works on all the S series cameras. But it does not work on the Lumix GX880, for example, and it also may not work on some of the older Lumix cameras. You just have to try it on your own camera and see if it works. And if you find this short tutorial useful, please buy me a cup of coffee. There's a link down below. And I'd also like to remind you that this following Sunday, the 15th of November, I'll be visiting Rob Trek's channel in a live stream together with Emily from Micro Four Nerds channel. We'll be talking about the Lumix gear and we'll be answering your questions as well. So please join in. And before you go, you may want to check out this video where I'll share my camera settings. You may find it useful after watching this video. Thank you so much and I'll see you in the next one.